we continue hearing from Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 2, text 41. Vyavaya sayatmika buddhir ekeha kuru nandana bahushakahi anantascha buddhayo avyavasayanam. Those who are on this path are resolute in purpose and the aim is one, O beloved child of the Kurus. The intelligence of those who are irresolute is many-branched. So this verse, when Srila Prabhupada, when he read the commentary by Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur on this verse, it gave him that inspiration that he had to do the service that his Guru Maharaj had told him to do, and that is to preach in the English-speaking language, to translate the books, to go to the West and preach. So a strong faith that by Krishna consciousness, one will be elevated to the highest perfection of life is called Vyavaya Sayatmika intelligence. So we should try to cultivate this strong faith that only by Krishna consciousness, that by following the process of Krishna consciousness, I am doing myself the greatest benefit. We are always thinking, if I get money, that will be the highest benefit for me. If I enjoy my senses, that will be the highest benefit. Because we all know time is short. Subconsciously, we know time is short. So we are trying to do some things that we think will benefit us. But we need to have this strong faith, strong firm faith, that it's only Krishna. Only by following the process of Krishna consciousness. Let me hear and chant. Let me hear and chant with faith, with determination, with patience, with enthusiasm. And that's the best thing that I can do for myself. You know, this is going to give me Krishna prema, highest perfection of life. This is the goal of human life. That is the only way that religion is properly followed in Kali Yuga. This is the Yuga Dharma. By doing this, I'm following the Vedas. The Caitanya Charitamrita Madhya 2262 states, Shraddha Shabde, Vishwas Kahesh Sudradha Nischaya, Krishne Bhakti Kaile Sarva Karma Krithaya. Faith means unflinching trust in something sublime. So we might have faith to the demigods, we might have faith. We might fear, I've been worshipping the demigods all along, and if I don't worship them, what will happen? They will punish me. But Krishna says, just surrender unto me and I will save you. I will save you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. We need to have that faith in Krishna. Why? Because he's our best friend. He's our best friend. He's our suhrit. When one is engaged, and so we should have that faith in us. And how do we get faith? By associating with devotees who have faith, associating with people who have faith. If we associate with people who do not have faith in Krishna, they will weaken our faith. They will tell us, oh, you're wasting time. There's better things to do. You should watch this TV, or you should make money, or you should do this, or go here, or go there, or speak here, or speak there. It'll be better. Because they themselves don't have faith. So what shall we do? What's the best interest? Associate with devotees who have faith in Krishna consciousness. When one is engaged in the duties of Krishna consciousness, he need not act in relationship to the material world with obligations to family traditions, humanity, or nationality. So what does it mean? Does it mean that a Krishna conscious person is irresponsible? He gives up his duties in society. Many people misunderstand this. People misunderstand that Krishna is saying, oh, you give up everything and whole day you sit and chat. No, Krishna is not saying that. Krishna is telling Arjuna, you do your duty, but you do it for my pleasure. So what does a Krishna conscious person do? Whenever he's acting in his position in society, he does it to the best of his ability for the pleasure of Krishna. Not that I will be happy with this, or let me do it because of fear of something or someone, or let me please this one or that one. No, a Krishna conscious person continues to act in whatever position he is or she is for the pleasure of Krishna. And that is Krishna consciousness, being conscious of Krishna, being conscious of what is going to make Krishna happy. And how do we know what is going to make Krishna happy? We inquire from the spiritual master, from the guru. He knows how to please Krishna, so he will teach us how to please Krishna. Fruitive activities are the engagement of one's reactions from past good or bad deeds. So fruitive activities means all the karma, what we like to do. I will do this because I will enjoy. I will do this, then I will get something, and with that I will enjoy. I will go here and I will enjoy. Or I will go there, I will enjoy. That is fruitive activities. We want to enjoy the fruit of that activity. That's why it's called fruitive activity. But when we engage in fruitive activity, we are creating more and more karmas for us. The karmas could be good or they could be bad. But we are creating more karmas. And the more karmas we create means we have to take so many more lives in the material world. It could be even we are taking birth in a higher planet, heavenly planet, but still it's the material world. So what shall we try to do? Act in a way for the pleasure of Krishna, connect our activities to Krishna so that we do not get this karma. We get detached from trying to enjoy the result of our activities. And then we get attached to Krishna, and like that, no need to come back to this material world. We can go back home, back to Golok. When one is awake in Krishna consciousness, he need no longer endeavor for good results in his activities. When one is situated in Krishna consciousness, all activities are on the absolute plane, for they are no longer subject to dualities like good and bad. So how does a person, a devotee in Krishna consciousness, what does he see? I just need to do this for the pleasure of Krishna. You know, I don't like to do it. I don't want to do it. I like to do it. I want to do it. He doesn't think that. He's just acting for the pleasure of Krishna. This will make Krishna happy. So I will do this because it makes Krishna happy. The highest perfection of Krishna consciousness is renunciation of the material conception of life. So why shall I act to make Krishna happy? Because I am not this body. I'm an eternal servant of Krishna. That is renunciation of the material conception of life. Because otherwise we are thinking we are the body, that I'm the enjoyer. This body belongs to me and let me enjoy it to the best of my capacity. That is material conception. But what is our true identity? As Lord Chaitanya taught us, Jivera Swarupaya Krishnera Nityadas. A living entity is an eternal servant of Krishna. This state is automatically achieved by progressive Krishna consciousness. So what do we have to do? We continue to hear and chant. Continue to hear and chant. Constantly hear and chant. The resolute purpose of a person in Krishna consciousness is based on knowledge. Vasudeva sarvam iti sa mahatma sudurlabha. Krishna says that in Bhagavad Gita 7 chapter. Vasudeva sarvam iti sa mahatma sudurlabha. What is he saying? That Vasudev is, that I am Vasudev, that I am the cause of all causes. There's nothing beyond me. That rare soul, that Mahatma is very rare. One to understand that Krishna is the Supreme Lord is very rare. Not easy for everyone to understand that. Not very easy. A person in Krishna consciousness is the rare good soul who knows perfectly that Vasudev or Krishna is the root of all manifested causes. That Krishna, everything comes from Krishna. Everything is emanating from Krishna. Krishna is the supreme father of everyone and everything. Everything belongs to Krishna. He's the root. Everything is connected to Krishna. There's nothing that is not connected to Krishna. That person is a rare good soul. And how do we get that? Hear and chant, hear and chant. As by watering the root of a tree, one automatically distributes water to the leaves and branches. So by acting in Krishna consciousness, one can render the highest service to everyone, namely self, family, society, country, humanity, etc. If Krishna is satisfied by one's actions, then everyone will be satisfied. So when we are watering a tree, we do not water the one leaf, one branch separately. No, we just take some water and water the root. By doing that, automatically the tree is healthy, is green, all the leaves are healthy, they are getting the water, the nourishment they need. But if we water one leaf and the branches and not water the root, what will happen? The tree will die. It will not get the nourishment it needs. So that's what we are doing. What we are doing, I will make this one happy, then I will be happy. I will make that one happy, then I will be happy. I will make my spouse happy, I will be happy. I will make my parents happy, I will be happy. I will make my mind and senses happy, and then I will be happy. But we see, no, it's not giving me the happiness that I'm looking for. It's still not giving me the satisfaction. It's not giving me the bliss. Why? Because we are not pleasing the root. The root is Krishna. So if we do our activities for the pleasure of Krishna, then Krishna will be happy and everyone will be happy with us. We will also be happy and everyone will be happy with us also. And so it's in our own interest if we work for the pleasure of Krishna, if we really want to be happy. Because we all want to be happy. That's what we are all looking for. But we don't know. We are thinking, if I make this body happy, if I make everyone who's happy related to my body, or if I make my mind and senses happy, mind and senses, like senses, if I eat whatever I want to see whatever I want to hear whatever I want, then I'll be happy, happy, happy. But nothing material will make us happy. Only when we please Krishna, then will we truly feel satisfied, truly feel happy. So, then, shall we stop here for today? How to be happy? How to serve Krishna? We have to take the guidance from a spiritual master, as we were saying. So that we can read about that tomorrow. So we'll stop here for today. Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gaur Premanande, Hari Bol, Hare Krishna.